So it is compressed like this. So this is the shape of Earth, oblate sphere, spheroid, or you can call it ellipsoid, or you can call it geoid. See, it is compressed by how much, guys? I want everybody to unmute and answer.
23 nautical miles.
23 nautical miles, correct. So polar diameter is less than equatorial diameter by 23 nautical miles, correct? Or equatorial diameter is bigger than polar diameter by 23 nautical miles. So if you minus PD from ED, PD is polar diameter, that means the diameter at the poles, ED means equatorial diameter, diameter at the equator, you will get 23 nautical miles. And Domino's Pizza number, call-free number is 688-688. And that's how we remember equatorial diameter is 688 nautical miles, correct? So in exam, if you don't remember polar diameter also, 688 minus polar diameter should be 23. So polar diameter is 6865, correct? Now we have seen compression of Earth. Compression of Earth is how much it is compared. So how much it is compressed when compared to the equatorial diameter here, how much here? 23. Okay. When I compare 23 divided by 688, I'll get 1/300 approximately. Correct. This is the compression of Earth. And if I want to express it as percentage, it is 0.3, and be careful and note down, it is not 0.03. Correct. And we have discussed this cardinal points are just northeast, south and west. These directions are called as cardinal points. Now, like in, if you take x-axis and y-axis, this is upper right quadrant, upper left quadrant, correct? So same way, if you take this diagram, northeast, southeast, southwest and northwest are called as quadrantal directions, right? Now sun rises in the east and sets in the west. Actually sun is not moving, Earth is moving from west to east, correct? So the rotation of the Earth is from west to east. And when viewed from top, see, west to east, it is anti-clockwise. But the same thing when viewed from bottom, from the south pole, it is clockwise. Correct. Next, inclination of Earth is 23.5 from where? From the normal axis. Normal axis is, if you take the plane of the Earth's orbit, the axis normal to this plane is normal axis. Correct. Normal means perpendicular or 90 degrees. So it is 23.5 degrees. Now, if you take inclination of Earth from the orbital plane, it is said to be 66.5 degrees. In exam, if you don't find 23.5, don't go for 23, go for 66.5, correct? Now, what is equator? Okay. So what is equator? See, Earth is inclined. Correct. Earth is inclined. Now, equator is a greatest possible circle that can be drawn on the Earth. Correct. See, on this ball, I can draw a circle like this also. Like this. Correct. I can draw a circle like this also. Correct. Like this also. Like this. I can draw many circles. But see, this line is the only greatest possible circle that I can draw perpendicular to this axis. Correct. Understood? So that is equator. Equator is a great circle. Great circle means the greatest possible circle that can be drawn on the axis of, on the Earth. Correct. It is a great circle. Here, I told you anything in aviation which is less than 1% is ignored. Correct. So Earth is compressed like this. How much? What is the value of compression expressed in percentage?
0.3%.
Correct. So it is less than 1%, obviously. So for all purposes in aviation, you take Earth as a perfect sphere, right? Nowadays, latest aircrafts are coming, which are even landing with the help of GPS, correct? So they consider something from World Geodetic Survey, 1984. It was taken a survey. What is the elevation of Earth? How is the real shape of the Earth, correct? So they use the latest technology, but as far as our licenses are concerned, we will not use any of that stuff. For us, Earth is a perfect sphere. Correct. So if Earth is a perfect sphere, how many great circles can I draw on this Earth?
Infinite.
Infinite. Correct. So I can draw a biggest possible circle like this also, like this also, like this also, like this also. Correct. Yes. Now I have told here these are the north poles and south pole, right? True north pole or geographic north pole, correct? Because Earth is a magnet, it will have a different magnetic north pole, correct? And north pole, magnetic north pole will keep on changing because inside the Earth, na, the lava will be floating, correct? Lava is like the liquid metal, which is very hot. It will be floating, correct, freely. So the north pole, na, it will keep on changing. What is the current position of north pole, anyone? Anyone has an idea in which country currently?
North Canada.
Yeah, it is in North Canada, correct. It will move, I believe, around 1 degree for every around 2.87 years. Not required. Okay. No. Then we have seen what is latitudes, correct? Can someone say what is the maximum latitude possible?
90 degrees.
90 degrees north, correct? So maximum latitude possible is 90 degrees north. Can someone say what is the maximum longitude possible?
180 degrees,
correct. Now see, for example, if you are flying an aircraft, okay, and for example I am flying and let us say ki Begumpet is trying to contact me and trying to take my position, okay, it will call me like Victor Tango Alpha Bravo Charlie Begumpet Tower, how do you read? Radio 5, sir, go ahead. Victor Tango Alpha Bravo Charlie, current position. Sir, I am inbound. What is this here? Begumpet. I am inbound Begumpet, 25 nautical miles on radial 122, speed so and so. Estimated time of arrival. This is how I give my position report. They say, ki, na, give us your coordinates. Then I'll touch my navigation display and I'll find out actual coordinates using the GPS where currently the plane is. Now, see, let's assume my coordinates are, let's say I'm at 20 degrees east north 130 degrees each, correct. Now, if I say, sir, my current coordinates are 20 degrees north and 130 east, everybody on the frequency who is listening to me will understand I am a amateur pilot, correct. See, it is like you have got a license to talk on RT, correct, RTR. The thing is, you have to be very professional on that. Correct. So your wording should be as such ki nobody will confuse. Sometimes 20 can be heard as 21, 22, something. Correct. The radio is not very, it's not like phone. The voice is not generally very clear. Correct. So how do you pronounce this? You pronounce this as 20 north, 130 east. Understand? Now, I'll give you another example. If, for example, you are at again 20 north and let's say you are at 90 degrees east, how do you say it?
20 north 90 east.
Onkar wrong. Anybody wants to try? Arsh.
20 north 090 east.
Very good. See, maximum latitude, longitude, see, this Arsh, is you're seeing the Earth from the top, correct? So this view is the Earth from the top and these are the longitudes. Longitudes are these things. These are the longitudes, correct? So they will start from zero and at the back of the Earth, it is 180 degrees. This is east, correct? And this is west direction, so 180 degrees west, correct? Maximum longitude. See, maximum longitude is 180 degrees, correct? So it can have three digits. Correct. Longitude can have three digits, but latitude will generally have two digits. So that's why you have to pronounce this as 20 north, 090 east. Am I clear? So if it is like 5 degrees south, 2 degrees east, how do you pronounce it?
05 south and 002 east.
Very good. Everybody understood, raise your hands.
So two digit and three digit.
Correct. So latitude is always two digits. So you pronounce two digits. So you pronounce this as 05 south, and you pronounce this as 002 east. Nobody will ask you in navigation exam, but I don't want my students to look amateur pilots. Clear? Shall I move on? Okay. Now you know what is latitude, longitude, correct? Okay. Graticule, by definition, is a map or a chart. Sorry, it's these are latitudes and longitudes when drawn on a map or a chart, not on real earth. Understood? So when drawn on a map or a chart, it is called graticule. See, on real earth, correct? On real earth, see, all the longitudes are converging at North Pole. Correct. All the longitudes are also converging at South Pole. Correct. But on a map, it will be like this. For example, this is a Mercator map. Mercator means it's a kind of map, which we will study in detail. Correct. In this, everything will be a North Pole, North Pole, North Pole, North Pole. North Pole. It will not converge. Correct. So this kind of representation, see, you cannot carry this thing. Correct. Carry one thread like this. And today I'm going from Bangalore to Hyderabad. Okay, let me measure. You cannot do this, na? Of course, there will be a lot of marking. So you have to carry a big globe in the cockpit. Correct. You cannot do this. So that's why you started using maps and charts. That means you can print this on a paper. Correct? But the problem is you cannot print a globe on paper very easily. That's why you use graticules. Understood? You understood the meaning of graticule here? Very important. Na? I don't want you to go wrong on this. So network of latitudes and longitudes when drawn on a map or a chart. Am I clear? I'll give you two examples and then I'll ask you to do the rest. Clear? Go from here. Unkar, tell me a random coordinate on Earth.
85 degrees south. 70 degrees north.
70 degrees. Yeah. I'm saying coordinate. Coordinate will consist of a latitude and a longitude. Correct. See, if I have to see here, this point is 30 degrees north, 20 degrees east. It will contain one latitude. That means from the equator, where is it? From the prime meridian, where is it? Understood? From the prime meridian, where is it? Correct. So tell me a valid coordinate.
East.
Now, Mantan, tell me a coordinate.
85 degrees north. Mm-hmm. 167 west.
West or east?
West.
If you want to go from here to here, what is the D lat and what is the D long? Answer in the WhatsApp group here. सुजल मंथन से आंसर This is 0 degrees, 180 degrees east or west. Azhar, here, see, you're going from 30 degrees, no? 30 degrees south to 85 degrees north, correct? So you're going towards which pole, north pole or south pole?
North pole.
You're going towards North Pole, then why your answer is south here?
Sorry, sir.
Okay, no issues, no issues. Okay. And then what was the other question? Going from 20 degrees east to?
No. Oh, yes. 167 west.
167 west. Correct. So this is 20 plus 167. See? 167 plus 20, how much?
187.
187 towards west.
West.
Now, if you calculate this, this will be 160. This will be how much?
13
degrees. So this will be how much?
173
degrees.
West.
East here. I'm going east now.
Yes, sir.
See, if you go east, you will reach your destination in 173 degrees. If you travel west, you will reach your destination in 187 degrees. Now, what will you do? Will you go the longer way or will you go the shorter way?
Shorter way, sir.
Correct. So, this is wrong. This is correct. Correct. In any case, if you don't travel the shorter way, believe me, it is like getting a job in an airline and losing the job on first day. Understand? Aviation is all about money, all about saving fuel, all about carrying the maximum payload, which you can. Correct? The companies do take it very seriously. Don't travel longer routes. Travel shorter routes. Understood? Is this clear? So always cross check. See, the total is 180, correct? Sorry, the total around Earth is 360. Correct? If one side it is more than 180, definitely the other side it should be less than 180. Understand? Am I clear on this? Okay.
Sir, Earth is also rotating. So we have to consider that also.
See, for example, you are traveling in a bus. Understand? So you are traveling in a bus and you see a mosquito. Correct. Will the mosquitoes, all mosquitoes be here attached on the back side of the bus glass window? No, no. They will be freely moving because see, once they are in bus, they achieve the velocity of bus. Correct. So once you are flying an aircraft on Earth, That means the aircraft, it doesn't matter. I mean, as per the aircraft, the earth is stationary. Understand?
For example, if you want to go to Delhi to Chicago, right? Then if we travel...
One second. Sorry for the interruption. See, it is like, I mean, I'll tell you a small thing.
Sir, Earth is traveling west to east, right? Anticlockwise. If we also travel west to east.
Earth is traveling west to east.
Like, yes.
Correct.
If we are going west to east.
Not only the Earth. The whole atmosphere around Earth is also traveling along with the Earth's surface. Clear? I mean, see, if you are saying that here, so today in Hyderabad, na, the wind is not there, nil winds. See, if this is Hyderabad, Hyderabad is moving like this, correct, west to east. But along with it, the wind is also moving. That's why there are no winds. Understand? So you never consider the angular velocity or rotation of Earth when you are in aircraft, because your aircraft when on ground has already achieved it. Correct. It is on the Earth already. For example, if you are coming from outer space, then you calculate. Am I clear, Mantan?
Yes. Sir, I'm getting confused with that east and west or this thing. I got the difference, this thing, how to calculate the difference, but east and west confusion is there.
Okay, fine. Let me go to Google Earth. So this is the Earth. This is the equator. These are the latitudes, equator, 10 degrees, 20 degrees, and these are the longitudes, correct? Correct. Let us find out where our prime meridian is. This is the anti-prime meridian. This is our prime meridian.
Correct.
Correct. And now, see, for example, if you are standing here in Africa, correct? Let us say, if you are standing here in Africa, correct? Now, if you go this direction, in which direction you are going?
East.
East. If you go from here in this direction, which direction you are going?
East only. East.
Correct. If you go like this, which direction you are going?
West.
West, na? See, if you are here, see, you are in the eastern side, but still, correct, you are on a latitude which is 10 degrees east. But if you go to 20 degrees east, that means you are going east.
Correct.
If you are going from 10 degrees east towards the equator, that means you are going west, na?
Okay. Or natural position to go.
Yeah.
Natural direction.
Yeah. So you have to take the position of the man on the ground or the aircraft on the ground. Correct. Now, if you go up like this, you're going north. If you're going down, you're going south.
Correct.
Yeah. Now, if I am here, correct. If I go like this, in which direction I am going?
East.
East. If I am going here, in which direction I am going?
West. West.
So if I am here, if I go like this, I am going north.
Correct.
If I come down, I am going south.
Yes.
If I go like this, in which direction I am going?
East.
East. If I go like this, in which direction I am going?
West.
Correct. Now, see, I told you for these kind of cases, see the Earth like this from the top view.
Yeah.
Correct. Now, I'll take one more photo. See, if you are standing here, See, if you go from 30 degrees east to 40 degrees east, in which direction you are going?
East only.
East. If you are here, if you are going like this, in which direction you are going?
East.
East. If you are going here, in which direction you are going?
East.
Still east. Correct. Now, if you are going here like this?
West.
West. If you are going here like this?
West towards the west.
West. So if you're going like this,
where, sir?
This one.
From west, west.
West. Correct. Now, see, from 10 degree west, if you're going like this, in which direction you're going?
West.
West. Like this?
West.
If you're going like this, which direction you're going?
East direction.
See, here, if you're going like this, in which direction you're going?
West.
See here, you're going from 160 east to 170 east.
East. Sorry, west.
See, no, see, this is the arrow, correct? Yeah. Tell me east or west.
West, sir.
Okay.
East, sir.
Correct. No. It is very quite common to get confused. Now see. If I am going from here to the here, you said east.
Correct.
Correct. If you are going from here to here, you said west.
Correct.
Correct. So all this direction is also west.
I can't hear you. Could you please repeat what you said?
Now see, if you go further, you may think here, this side, na, I'm going left hand. This here, I'm going right hand. Correct. This is what you're getting confused. Correct. But still, you're going west. Because if you stand here, see, Earth is rotating from west to east, na, like this. So this is east. You will see the sun here. Understand? Same diagram. If I draw here, this is the Earth. This is the North Pole. Correct. This is 0 degrees, 10 degrees, 20 degrees, so on and so forth. Here it will be 90 degrees east. Correct. This is east direction. Now, here 100 degrees to 110 degrees. Correct. This is also east. This is also east direction. This is also east direction. Am I clear? See, for example, if a guy is standing here, correct? If he comes up towards North Pole, for him, it will be north. Correct? If he goes like this, this will be east for him. This will be west. Clear? So this is also east. This will also be east. This will also be east. Because see, if you go 10 degrees west, 20 degrees west, 30 degrees west, this direction is west direction. Clear? Understood. So this direction is west direction. Am I clear, Omkar? Okay, see. I'll give you homework today. Okay, so you do the homework. You try to imagine the Earth. Okay, so if you don't understand, go to Google Earth. Okay, Google Earth and try to mark. See, try to mark a point like this. Correct. For example, I gave you from, let's say, 20 degree east to 40 degrees west. Correct. Go to 20 degrees east. Here, this is the 20 degrees east longitude. Correct. where I'm going, I am going 40 degrees west. Correct. Which direction is this? East or west?
West.
West, obviously correct. Now, let's say you're going in this direction, east direction, correct? Let's say you're going from 150 degrees east to 150 degrees west. Which direction you will go?
East, sir.
East, correct. If you go from 130 to 80 degrees west?
Then it is east only.
Very good. I think you understood.
Okay.
Am I clear? So, I mean, sure. You can also say if you're saying from North Pole, anti-clockwise is east direction.
Anti-clockwise full it is east and clockwise full it is west.
West. But see, that is a mnemonic or some kind of, I mean, see, if the 3D picture of the earth is not sitting in your brain as a pilot, na, you're thinking anti-clockwise or clockwise. No. Correct. So I want you to have that thing printed in the brain. Clear? Practice. If you have any doubt, we'll again discuss.
Sir. Yes. Sir, it's like the equator, the prime meridian is also fixed.
No. Here, keep your speaker close.
And so as like the equator, the prime meridian is also fixed.
As like?
The equator. So it can.
Yeah, prime meridian is also fixed. I told you, na. See, if you see this, this is the Europe, correct? Somewhere here, this is London. And somewhere here, it is Greenwich. So from here, the prime meridian passes through the Greenwich, correct? It is fixed. Right?
Okay,
prime meridian and anti-meridian are fixed. Okay, like the equator. They make a complete circle, correct? Now, question to you. Equator is a dash circle. Is it a small circle or a
great
circle?
Now, meridian is a
semi-great circle.
Very good. See, it is not a great circle. See, meridian goes from North Pole to South Pole, correct? So that is half of the great circle, not the complete part. So in exam, you have to take semi-great circle. Am I clear? Now, meridian plus exactly its opposite side, anti-meridian. This will make a great circle. Understood? Meridian plus its anti-meridian will make a great. For example, prime meridian plus anti-prime meridian will make a great circle. 10 degrees east plus 170 degrees west will make a great circle. Understood? Am I clear? Next. Here, see, today class will be easy peasy class. Okay. Very interesting class. Here, if you understand today, na, like your general navigation syllabus is already over. If you don't understand today, na, your general navigation syllabus will not be over after me completing the syllabus. Okay. If you have any doubt, you stop me. Correct? You stop me and ask. So I'll be teaching you what is a great circle, what is a rhomb line, correct? The basics only. And if you understand these two, I'll move ahead and teach what is a nautical mile, what is a kilometer, I mean, how we draw kilometers, and small topic, geocentric and geodetic latitudes. Now, before going there, I'll teach you how to use a scientific calculator. Arsh, I think you're beta, correct?
Yes, sir.
So you know scientific calculator, what is it?
Yes, sir.
Now see, it will look like this. I will show my controls on this, correct? Because I'm using Apple products, there is actually not, I could not get an app which is exactly looking like this, but almost whatever I can do with this, I can do this with this calculator also. Correct. Now, see, if I take, let's say I'm going from, let this be the equator. I'm going from, let's say 10 degrees to, let's say here is 11 degrees. 10 degrees north to 11 degrees north. Correct. Now see, this place is divided into 60 equal parts. Correct. For example, if you take 1 hour, 1 hour is divided into 60 minutes. Correct. So 1 degree is divided into 60 minutes. It is not like a clock, but still they use the same convention. How many of you understood? Now, here, if you take 1 minute, na, if you take this 1 minute, na, that 1 minute is further divided into 60 seconds. 1 minute is further divided into 60 seconds. Correct. That means 1 degree has how many seconds?
3600.
Very good. See, 1 degree has 60 minutes. Correct. Each minute has 60 seconds. So 1 degree has 3600 seconds. How many of you understood, right? Correct. Next. See, if I want to write, for example, degrees, 15 minutes,
mm-hmm,
and 20 seconds. Yep. Mother mute here. I will write like this. 30 degrees is represented by a zero. Correct. Minutes is represented by a small dash. Correct. Seconds is represented by two small dashes. Am I clear? Okay. Do the first question. Find the chi lag between these two points, these two latitudes. This is the equator. 52 degrees 15 minutes north, you're going to 39 degrees 35 minutes north. Right. So what is the direction in which you are going? Towards which pole? South pole. Correct. Now this total is 52 degrees 15 minutes. This is 39 degrees 35 minutes. So you have to get this. Correct. So that means 52 degrees 15 minutes minus 39 degrees, 35 minutes. You do it. Try to use your brains. Don't use calculators.
Sir, can you scroll the page?
Like this?
No, that degrees, minutes.
This is the question.
Sir, I did not take down that upper or whatever.
Okay. Give me a second. Or you guys do it. Mandan, you have sent two answers?
Yes, sir.
Okay, next one also you read.
Yes.
Okay, fine. Shall I do this? Manually. Okay, I'll show you manually. And this will be the last time where you will do it manually. Okay. So after this, every time you will use only calculator, even in the exam, even in the cockpit, because this is now a bit complicated. Correct. People will confuse. You should never confuse in your calculations if you are a pilot. See, 52 degrees, 15 minutes minus 39 degrees, 35 minutes. Correct. Now you can minus 39 from 52, but you cannot minus 35 from 15. Correct. So can I write this as 51 degrees? See, if I decrease 1 degree, I am getting 60 minutes plus. Correct. So I'll write 60 plus 15 would be 75 minutes. Correct. Minus 39 degrees, 35 minutes. 0, 7 minus 3 would be 4. 51 minus 39, how much here? 2, 1. 12 degrees, 40 minutes is the answer. By the way, Mandan is correct. Darwin, how did you get 17 minutes 35? Okay, I understand. Is this understood, everyone? But here, this is not very viable here.
Sir, why do we reduce that from 52 to 51?
Because see, I want to minus 35 from 15. Correct? Can I do it? No. So I see 1 degree I minus, correct? It will become 51. But how many minutes I gained? 60.
60.
Correct. 51 degrees, 75 minutes is same as 52 degrees, 15 minutes in terms of calculations. So from this, I can easily minus both of the things, correct? But never do this. This is a very bad method. See, I'm giving an example for a bad method. Correct. Always do like this. Now see how to do this. Enter 52 degrees. See, how do you enter degrees? Do you see this button? In your 1, 2, 3, third row, second button.
Yeah.
Correct. If you press that once, like this button, it will enter degrees. Correct. Next, 15 minutes. Correct. 15, if I press that again, it will enter, give minutes. Minus 39 degrees, 35 minutes. That will give my answer. 12 degrees, 40 minutes, which I calculated is correct.
And sir,
yes.
That 15 minutes, how to add?
No. Don't add. See, 52, you press this one button once. Degrees it became. Correct. So 52, I press this button, it became degrees. Next, continue 15 and write minutes. Clear?
Where is that minute in the scientific?
Minute. Same button. If it is pressed again, it will become, it will again show degree kind of thing, na? That will enter as minute.
Okay.
Understood. Minus 39 degrees, 35 minutes. Clear? Now, using calculator only, do all these things. Okay. Do this. Done? Here, there are no answers in the group yet. Azure, you are correct.
Sure, I will send you.
See, for this question, the answer is 109 degrees, 55 minutes. These two answers are 201 degrees, 15 minutes, and 5 degrees, 40 minutes. Correct. So, did everybody get the same answer or different answers?
So 201.
Sir, I got different answers for all three.
For all three?
Yes, sir. You have to find the difference, sir.
No. Why do you find the difference here? See, you're going from north to south in this case, na? You're going from where? You're going from 49 degrees, 35 minutes latitude, north latitude. You're going to 60 degrees, 20 minutes south latitude. Correct. So you go to equator first and then go like this. So total south, and 49 degrees, 35 minutes is this, and 60 degrees, 20 minutes is this. So in this case, you will add, na, Onkar. Why did I ask you to subtract? I said find Chilat.
Sir, for second question, my answer is 49 degrees, 55 east. First one.
Okay, you're correct. Generally, I teach here, na, that example. Ki you have to follow the shortest distance. I understand. Okay. I mean, this is a decoy question. What is the answer, Manthan?
49 degrees, 55 minutes west.
55 minutes?
West.
And 5 degrees, 40 minutes.
Yes. West. West.
Is this clear?
What is the answer for the first one?
Your first one answer is 109 degrees, 55 minutes south. Got it?
Yes, sir.
Now,
sir, can you explain that second one?
Can I
explain that second question?
You want to explain it to everyone?
No, sir. Please explain me.
Okay, explain.
Please explain me, sir. I did not get that.
You want me to explain?
Oh, this is Chi Long. Okay.
This is Geelong, na? Where you have to see the earth from the top view to make it easy, to make things easy.
Good.
Take a minute time, do first one. Okay, do this one. Or here, wait. Don't do that. It will take a long time. Do this. 1 degree, 20 minutes east. 4 degrees, 20 minutes west. Arsh, I believe your internet connection is not stable.
Yes, sir. My connection was not stable. I got disconnected, sir.
Okay, no issues. Here, you try this, na? This one. I'll move forward.
Yes, sir.
See, whenever you need a break, you guys, you let me know. Unka, do it fast here.
5 degrees, 40 minutes west.
5 degrees?
40 minutes west.
Arsh? What is your answer?
Sir, I haven't solved it.
Huh?
Sir, I haven't solved it yet. I'm solving right now. So my connection was disconnected. So
okay, fine, no issues. Here, see. For example, please make sure for the next 10 minutes, na, your connection will be stable because it is very important. Next 10 minutes is very important. Here, see. Even though being a medical student, na, my diagrams are generally bad. I'll try to do my best. Arsh, show me how do you eat. Show me how do you eat.
So, from...
Show me. It's all technical. See, Azhar is
from south.
Azhar is showing.
If
Azhar shows again, how do we? See, show na, show. It na, like this. Not like this, like this. No na, anybody eating like this? Okay, so everybody is eating like this only. Pakka, sure, okay. That means here from the table, the food should go in the shortest way possible to your mouth. Why do you do it? It will save your energy. Right? If you go like this, you're going the long way. Right? See, for example, let us go to Google Earth. Okay. So let me see, where am I? Oh, not so close. Okay. This is the building in which I am staying now, currently. Okay. Now you can mark the latitude also. Now see. I want to go from this point. Okay. From you see my cursor? I want to go from this point, correct? Near this tree to this point. How will I go? I'll go in a straight line. Correct. Now see, if I have Iron Man suit, I want to go from this point, crossing the Hussein Sagar Lake to Buddha statue. Correct. Where is the Buddha statue? Sir is here. Correct. Sir is here. So how will I go if I have a Superman, or if I am a Superman, or I have this guy who is this Iron Man suit? Here I will fly directly from here to here. Correct. So I'll fly directly from here to here in a straight line. Oh, not like that here. I'll not go. I'll eat with directly. Correct. Understood. Now see, if I want to go from the place where I am here to, let's say, Shadnagar. Okay. Again, I will go on the shortest possible route. Correct. Let's say I want to go from this place to, let's say, Goa. Let us go Goa. Okay. So this line, if I draw a line like this, if I draw a line like this, okay. This is the shortest possible, right? Correct. Now, let me show you who will eat like this. Correct. I'll show you who will eat like this. Do you see this guy? Number one bullshit guy. See, he wants to go from somewhere in US to UK. See, is he going in a straight line? No, correct. So he is going in a longer way. Correct. Oh, don't wait. Others doesn't know. Correct. Let me explain that. You take any aircraft. See this guy. Bigger bullshit guy. Going in a long way. Correct. See, actually, he is not a bullshit guy. He is a very good pilot. He is flying the shortest possible distance. But shortest possible distance, if it is represented on a map, is a curved line. Correct. So I'll come back to it later. First, let me teach you how to find out the shortest possible distance between two places. Correct. Now, let me take a point. I'll add a point here, like where I am. Correct. Now, see here, tell me a beautiful destination where you want to go in the world.
Kabul, sir.
Huh?
Kabul, Afghanistan.
Where? Kabul.
Yes.
Very good. You want to send me to Kabul? Very good students here. Very good students. Okay. Now, do you see? If I zoom in, correct. If I zoom in, from my position to Kabul is a straight line. Understood? But see, if I take this to the edge of the globe and rotate it, do you see that faint line is fitting a curve? Correct. So if I rotate it exactly, correct, I can make it the edge of this circle, this great circle, correct? Obviously, this is a great circle. Correct. That means your shortest line between two points is an arc of great circle, always. Of course, it is a straight line on Earth. It is definitely a straight line on Earth, but Earth is curved not like this. Understand? So, if I draw a great circle joining two points, correct, like this, for example, I'll show. Correct. Now, if I put it like this, and I counter zoom it. Right. Now, take a screenshot. Do you see the dot? This is where I am. Correct. So if I follow the line which we have driven, this is Kabul. Correct. Afghanistan. Correct. Now see, I can draw a great circle like this. So, the shortest possible distance between Kabul and my place is a part of a great circle. Understand? So, anywhere you want to go from one place on Earth to other place, here it will be a straight line. Correct? Straight line is the shortest possible distance. Correct. But see, If I take a globe, correct, and from far away, this is a straight line. From far away, do you see this is a straight line? Do you see the blue line? Correct. Now, but if I remove the globe and if I align this blue line exactly so that it will form a circle, great circle, correct. Do you see that shortest possible distance is a great circle? How many of you understood this? Okay. Let me give you more clarity. Again, which is the country that invaded India?
Greenwich.
Britain.
It's British. Correct.
Yes, Britain.
Now see, in good olden days, they had only one compass. Correct. Now, see, let's say this is, let's say this point is, let's say X, and they want to reach this point, which is Y. Correct. Now, what they do, they used to use a compass here from, if this is my north, na, because this see, sorry. Do you see? This is the north direction. Correct. From here, they used to see here, if I go theta, correct. Now from here also, I'll measure my theta angle, same angle, correct. But see, the north direction, which is initially like this, now as it comes, it is changing like this. Correct. Here it is changing. See, on Earth, the north direction is not constant. For this place, it is like this. For this place, it is like this. Correct. So you to reach Y, if you follow a path of constant track, theta. That means like here, if you go from, if you take a compass and if you go like constantly 30 degrees na, from X, you will reach Y. But is it the shortest path to reach Y? No. Do you see? It is curved. It is like a helix. Understood? But if you draw a straight line, this is the shortest path. This is straight line. You may think this is a curve. This is a curve because the earth is curved. But if I adjust the earth and see it from the top, it is a straight line. Understood? How many of you understood? Okay, fine. Here now, so if I have to go from point A to point B, I will draw a straight line on Earth. Correct. So that straight line on Earth, if you extend it, it will be a part of great circle. This is A, this is B, correct. So shortest distance is an arc of great circle. Now, see, if you take A and B, how many great circles can you draw passing through A and B? Option one, only one. Option two, infinity. Unmute and answer here.
One.
See, you can draw only one great circle. No? Understand? But let's say if point B is here and point A is here, that means exactly they are on opposite sides of the globe. Then see, you can draw a great circle like this also. Correct. Even this is a great circle from A to B. Correct. If B is here and A is here. Correct. So you can draw between two points only one great circle, But if the two points are diametrically opposite, you can draw infinite grid circles. For example, I'll tell you, if this is North Pole, if this is South Pole, you go through any longitude, it will be same distance. Na? Understand? How many of you understood this? So,
sir, if it is exactly opposite, then infinite, right?
Infinite.
Okay.
If not, if you
and when it is only one
and B, there is only one.
Okay. Got it.
Correct. Between two points, only one GC track or circle track can be drawn unless the two points are diametrically opposite on Earth. How many of you understood this line? Between two points, you can draw only one GC track unless the two points are diametrically opposite on Earth. Raise your hands, how many of you understood? Yesterday we have discussed, na, great circle is the greatest possible circle on Earth. Correct. Largest possible circle that can be drawn on the surface of the Earth. Of course, every great circle will divide Earth into two equal parts. Correct. So if I chop this at a great circle, up northern hemisphere at equator, northern hemisphere, southern hemisphere. Correct. So it will divide into two equal parts. See, do you see this? If this is Earth, correct, this is the radius of the Earth, correct, from the center to the surface. But see, for this great circle also, this is the radius of Earth, correct. That means if you take any great circle, the radius will be same as the radius of Earth, obviously, correct. And of course, the center of Earth is the center of great circle. Understood this line? Correct. Imagine Earth. Draw a great circle. Okay. Center will be, of course, center of this great circle, equator. Yeah. Okay, fine. How much will be there? Oh, same. Understood? Correct. So it will have same radius and same center as that of Earth. Correct? For a great circle. Now, GC track is the shortest distance on the surface of the Earth. That means if the shortest distance, see, you may think here, this is a curve, na? I'll show you. Correct. I should show you again. Correct. You may think here, see, doesn't it look like a straight line? From here to here, correct. So actually on Earth, GC track is a straight line. Raise your hands. How many of you will agree? Correct. So GC track on Earth is a straight line. Write down. GC track on Earth is a straight line. Correct. Now, do you see the bigger picture? Correct. Now, if I take a screenshot of this, and if I complete the great circle, it will look like this. On the opposite side of the Earth, it will come. Understood? So how it is coming, the great circle. So see, if this is the center of the Earth, from the center, this is the radius of the Earth, also the radius of this great circle. Correct. So center of the Earth and center of this great circle will coincide, obviously. How many of you understood? Correct. Fine. Let's see. If you have a, let's say, big antenna at a position X and your aircraft is at position B. Correct. Not B, let's say Y. Your aircraft is at position Y. Now your antenna will give waves in all directions. correct? But see, the first wave to reach the aircraft and the only wave to reach the aircraft will be the wave which is following the shortest or possibilities of the straight line, correct? Correct. If the aircraft is here, if I throw a signal like this, then that will be the shortest distance. And of course, if I throw everywhere also, this straight wave which went to the aircraft will reach the aircraft, correct? So that means, see, it is said that radio signals, na, they follow great circle tracks. How many of you understood this? Correct. So write down, all radio signals follow GC tracks. Correct. See, it will not go like this. If it wants to go from A to B, it will go like this. Correct. A straight line. It will not go like this, or it will not go like this, or it will not go like this. Nothing doing. It will go in a straight line. How many of you understood? Correct. Very clear. Okay. If you take this, equator is a great circle or a not?
Correct. Great circle.
Correct. Now, if you take North Pole and if you take South Pole, what is this? If you take any meridian, meridian is a great circle or not?
Semi-great circle.
It is a semi-great circle. That means if you are traveling along a meridian, you are traveling in the shortest possible circle. Understood? Correct. So if you are traveling along the equator, you are traveling the shortest possible circle. This line also understood? Correct. So meridian plus antimeridian, it forms a
great circle.
Correct. Understood these lines? For example, this meridian is 20 degrees west. What is this antimeridian? What is this value?
20 degrees east.
You're saying, see, this is the 20 prime meridian and 20 degrees east would be here. Correct. See, I want on the opposite side of the earth, which
200.
Is 200 is not there on earth.
Then, sir, 160 east.
Very good. Very good. Very good. See. This is prime meridian and this is 20 degrees east. Correct. So for if I want to find out the antimeridian, see the line which is going opposite to this. Correct. Always add 180. Correct. If you add 160, you will go to prime antimeridian and add 20. So I was at 20 west, correct?
Sorry. Yes.
So 20 west. From here, if I go 180, till here it is 20. 20. Correct. I have 160 more. So I'll end up 160 east. See, do you see 160 east? If I draw a straight line, we'll go to 20 west. Right here. So, or if I zoom like this, and if I take a screenshot, and if I trace 120 west, this will definitely be 160 degrees east. Correct. See, if this is 180 degrees east or west, this is 170 degrees east, this is 160 degrees east. How many of you understood? Raise your hands.
So the total should be 180, right?
Yeah, total should be 180. Correct. You should travel 180 degrees. Correct. It's not the total. You should travel 180 degrees. Correct. How many of you really understood? Correct. Shall I give you one more question? Find the antimeridian of let's say A 90 degrees east, B 45 degrees west, C 120 degrees east. Answer it fast. You can answer directly. No need to do it in the chat.
110 west.
What is the answer for this?
90 degrees.
90 degrees west longitude.
West.
Right. See, if you see the earth from the top, this is north pole. This is 0 degrees. This is 90 degrees east, and the opposite will be 90 degrees west. Correct. From here it is 90 degrees. From here it is 90 degrees. So total 180 degrees, and sine is west.
135 east.
135 east. 60 degrees west.
45 west would be 45. Correct. How much more? Yeah, 135. Total 180. Correct. 135 degrees west. 135 degrees west. Now 120 east. So 90 here, it will be 120 degrees east. So from here, if you go to 180, how much it is?
60 degrees west.
60 degrees west.
So you have to go how much more? 120. 120 minus 160 degrees west. How many of you understood? Or simply you can do here. See?
180 minus.
Yeah. 180 minus.
See, I'll tell you one more thing. 90 say this is to this side by how much? 30 degrees. Correct. So 90 say this will be on this side 30 degrees. So 90 degrees west will become 60 degrees west. Shortcut. Correct. Once you know the understand the geometry of earth, you can play with things. Am I clear? Everybody understood? See, olden days, na, people found out the great circle after a long time. Great circle is a recent invention, recent discovery, correct? Olden days, na, they used to have a compass here. If I go 30 degrees, I'll reach Y, correct? See, what happens if you go on going 30 degrees? You will actually spiral into the pole because all the longitudes meet. Na. Understand? How many of you understood this? Correct. So if you keep on going 30, 30, 30, 30, 30, 30, 30, 30, 30, 30, 30, 30, finally you will spiral into pole. Correct. So this kind of line is called a rhomb line. Or this track is called as a RL track, rhomb line track. This has a another name called as loxodrome. Correct. It is a line of constant direction. Correct. Now tell me, is great circle a line of constant direction?
Yes.
Absolutely false. Great circle is not a line of constant. I'll show you. See, the longitudes on the earth are like this. They converge into the north pole. They converge into the south pole. Correct. Now, if I draw a straight line on earth from A to B, correct. See, this is the local north at A. Correct. Let's say it is 57. Correct. Now at B, it is tilted this side. Correct. If you see, it is getting more tilted. If you see here, it is more tilted. See, it became more obtuse angle. Correct. It was an acute angle, 57. It became 102. Correct. So if you are following, if you are flying a GC track,
so what is acute angle?
Acute means like I just used it. And anything below
acute 90, is less than 90 degrees.
Anything below 90, you call it as acute, and anything more than 90, you call it as obtuse. Like in trigonometry in school, I used to use this, but that is not the correct terminology to use this in class. Okay, as a pilot, you will never use this. Okay, that's a general term. Correct. So if you are flying a GC track, here you are going the shortest distance. Also, you are flying on Earth in a straight line. But the problem is on Earth, the longitudes are converging into each other. Correct. They are not parallel lines. Correct. So that's why, for example, if they are parallel lines, correct, then if you draw like this, you will have same angle. But on real earth, na, they are converging. Na? Correct. So this is the reality we have to face. So, but the longitudes are converging into north and south poles. That is, they are not parallel to each other. So GC track, in order to maintain the shortest distance possible, because it is a straight line, is a track which changes its direction constantly. Correct. So GC track direction will constantly change. How many of you understood this really? Correct. Now see, do you see this track? So everywhere it is making 45, 45, 45, 45. Correct. Can someone say what track is this? Correct.
Rumline.
Correct. So this is a rumline track. Is this the shortest distance?
No.
No. Correct. So this is the shortest distance between A and B. Correct. You can go from A and B in a constantly curved line. Correct. Constantly curved means like everything is 45 degrees, but it will be a long distance. How many of you also understood this? Correct. This is the difference between GC track and rumbling track. Here, I want you to write down this sentence.
So,
yes.
Sir, I have a doubt. Sir, traveling in all the longitudes will change the direction, right?
Can you come closer to your microphone?
Sir, traveling in longitudes will always change the direction. Not for the great circle, I think.
What?
Sir, traveling in longitudes, along the longitudes, along all the longitudes will change the direction.
No, no. See, you are saying the word traveling along the longitude. Is this correct? What are you saying?
Yes, sir.
Here, if you're traveling along a longitude, let's say you're traveling from A to B, correct? You are going along a meridian, correct? See, meridian is a semi-great circle, correct? So this is the shortest possible distance. Understood? See, I am talking about going from X to Y. Correct? If you're going from X to Y, so this angle, great circle track will constantly change. Do you see here? It was, let's say, 20 degrees, correct? Now see, the north is here like this. By the time you reach, this angle is, because you are traveling like this, this angle is, let's say, 105 degrees, correct? It constantly increases. Sometimes it constantly decreases also, correct? 20 degrees, 30 degrees, correct? 40 degrees. Somewhere it will become 70 degrees, correct? So on and so forth. Understood?
Yes, sir.
Right now,
while we are flying on the meridian, then GC and RL are same.
I'll come to that point. Just give me 2 minutes. Okay. I did not teach you that yet.
Sir, in rum line, that angle is constant, right?
Correct.
So the line is also, the line is constant.
Angle is constant. See, for a rum line,
angle is constant, so direction is constant.
Yeah. So direction is constant. So, but your north is constantly changing. Na? See, here it is like this, but here it is like this in space. Understood? So even though angle is constant, the line will constantly curve.
But it is the longest distance, not the shortest.
Yes, it is longer than great circle. Correct. See, if I want to go to next room, okay, this room, I can go like this, I can get down, I can go to Delhi on my bike and take a U-turn and come and go to that room. So that will be longer.
That is okay. That is like a rum line.
No. I'm saying, see, it is longer than Great Circle. It is not the longest distance. See, you can travel like this also. This is longer than Great Circle, longer than rum line. Correct. So I'm saying, when compared to Great Circle, if you travel in a track which takes you to your destination, but you, if you travel in a constant direction, correct. So that will be a long distance. That will be longer distance when compared to longer distance than the GC track, correct? Because GC track is the shortest possible distance. No distance can be shorter than this if you take two points on Earth, correct? Because I showed you, na, on Google Earth, correct? See the line, correct? So if you take this, this is the straight line. You're going from Africa to some place in this sea, correct? Okay, so it forms a part of Great Circle. Understood?
Correct.
You can draw a Great Circle like this. Here, if you don't understand, you tell me, I'll teach you 100 times. No issues. Okay,
sir. We are using GC tracks while routing flying, right, sir?
Yes.
But sir, GC tracks maintain. No. But sir, direction are different, sir.
It constantly changes.
How we maintain track?
That's what, na? That's what all about convergency chapter is all about, calculating GC tracks. Correct. On the aircraft, the computer does it. INS will constantly calculate and change your aircraft direction slowly to make it follow GC track. Inertial navigation system. You remember? INS will follow GC tracks, correct? Even the GPS does follow GC tracks. It will constantly keep you changing direction, keep changing direction. Shall I move on? Correct.
Sir, tracks are magnetic, right? Tracks are magnetic.
See, till I teach you.
While we are reading compass.
No. Until we go to the next chapter, we will imagine all the tracks we are taking are true tracks measured from true north. Correct. Because then I did not teach you guys variation. Correct. So give me 3 days. I'll take you. First, let us understand the true tracks. And then we will go to magnetic tracks. Correct. So how the variation varies in different places. Okay.
So rum line is the line of constant direction, is like the meaning of that.
That means from the north, wherever you are, this will be 15 degrees. Correct. So it is like a constant direction track. Correct.
Which is longer than the GC track.
Which is longer than the GC track, obviously. Correct. Because GC track is the shortest possible distance.
Okay. Oops.
Correct. Give me 5 minutes.
This 15 degree is respective to all the longitude, right?
Correct. See, always, how do you measure your track where you are going from your local north? If you are standing here, see, if I am standing here, if my north is here, correct. So from here, I'll come like this, correct. So now, see, if you take two guys, one standing here, for him, this is the north direction, correct. If you take another guy who is standing here, correct. For this guy, this is the north direction. Okay, towards the north pole. How many? You see, it will make sense. It will make sense as you go into the chapter. Okay, this is the first day. It's cool. Okay. I mean, if when I was reading navigation on my first day, I did not understand this much. As much you guys understood today. Yet I had a lot of doubt. But I believe you understood a lot. Your concept is a lot clearer than mine. It will get clear as you go into syllabus, as you do more problems, as you go into convergence, na, it will become super clear. And after maps and charts, na, okay, you will play with these topics.
Understand? Sir, what is that LOXO?
What is that?
LOXO. What do you have written that? A rum line.
LOXO.
LOXO. See. The other name for rumb line is loxodrome. Other name for rumb line is loxodrome. See, can I say rumb line is a track which cuts all the meridians at same angle?
90 degrees.
Correct. So, let's say 15 degrees, 15 degrees, 15 degrees, 15 degrees, and you reach your destination. Correct. So, it cuts the meridians at same angles. Correct. Or, it is a line of constant true direction. Correct. Because we are measuring from true north, not with a compass. Okay. I just said compass key to make you understand things. Okay. We are not measuring from magnetic north. We are measuring from true north, north pole, or geographic north pole. Correct. 15, 15, 15. It's a line of constant true direction. Okay. Now see, if you take any parallel of latitude, correct, here, these are parallels of latitudes, correct? Now, if you take any parallel of it, they make same 90 degrees, 90 degrees, 90 degrees, 90 degrees, 90 degrees, correct? So, they make 90 degrees, 90 degrees, 90 degrees, 90 degrees, 90 degrees. I mean, if you rotate there, then free some and see from there, it will still be 90 degrees, correct? So, can I say here, if you are traveling along a parallel of latitude, you are traveling in a rumb line. Can I say that? How many of you will agree? Nobody. Correct. See, from the north, it is making 90 degrees. It is also making 90 degrees, 90 degrees, 90 degrees. So, if you are traveling along a parallel of latitude or latitude, it is that you are traveling along a rumb line. Correct. So, all parallels of latitudes are rumb lines. That means all latitudes on Earth are rumb lines. Understood? Now see, if you take equator also, it is also making 90 degrees, 90 degrees, 90 degrees, 90 degrees. Correct. But see, equator is a GC, it's a great circle. But it is also making 90 degrees with all the meridians. That's why equator is called a GC and a rumb line. How many of you understood this? Correct. So, equator is a GC as well as a rumb line. Now, if you draw any rumb line, it will always spiral into the nearest pole. Correct. But see, are the parallels of latitudes are spiraling to the nearest pole? No. Correct. So, you can write RL tracks spiral to the nearest poles except latitudes or parallels of latitudes. Correct. Now, see, when I gave my navigation exam, this was the sentence I saw in the exam. Correct. All rumb line tracks spiral into the nearest pole. Is it true or false?
True.
Anyone else?
False.
False. See, I made you right. RL tracks spirals in nearest pole except parallels of latitudes. Correct. They are not spiraling. They are constant circles. But as far as DGCA is concerned, take this sentence as a true sentence. Correct. So I lost a mark here. Correct. So they have a convention key, all rumb line tracks should spiral into the nearest pole and you take it as true. Correct. Write down star and strike it off as false. Correct. Because see, I know the concept now. I will think it is false. But you also have to understand that someone has written this statement in a book and someone made a question out of it. Clear? Here, take a break. I will see you at 2 o'clock. Okay, I'll complete the class by 3 o'clock. Okay.
Sir.
Yes.
That equator is a great circle, that is understood, as well as rum line.
See, any rum line track will make a constant angle with all the meridians. Correct.
Correct.
Equator is also making 90 degrees, 90 degrees, like all the parallels of latitudes, correct? 90 degrees, 90 degrees. So it is making a constant angle, na?
Okay.
So equator is a rum line as well as a great circle. Am I clear?
Understood?
Yes.
Now, see, I'm giving you 20 minutes. Okay. You have a snack, correct? You go through all these two lines. Okay. These two pages. I'll leave it here like this. Okay. So go through every line of these two pages. Correct. If you have a doubt, again, I'll discuss after break. Am I clear on this? Okay. Fine. Take a break. Here, Ash, you need not leave the meeting. Okay. You can just turn off your camera and mic. That's all. Okay. That's how we take breaks. I'll see you at 2 p.m. Have something and come. Your question was, what is the meaning of all parallels of latitudes are rum lines?
Correct. Correct.
See, these are parallels of latitudes. Correct. Latitude. Now, every latitude makes 90 degrees with the meridian. Correct. So, this is 90 degrees, 90 degrees, 90 degrees, 90 degrees, 90 degrees. Here, by definition, rum line track is the track which makes constant angle with all meridians. Correct. In this case, 15, 15, 15, 15, constant angle. Correct. In this case, constant angle, 90, 90, 90, 90, 90. Correct. So, parallels of latitudes are rum lines.
So, latitude is also a rum line. Equator is also a rum line.
Equator is also a rum line, but equator is also a great circle. So equator is both great circle and rum line.
Just because of the constant angle.
Correct.
Okay.
Correct. So call it a rum line. The track should have a constant angle with the true north.
Yes.
Clear? It will become more clear in 1 or 2 days. It will become super clear. You will play with this kind of topics.
So GC track, it will not follow the constant angle, but it is a shorter.
It is the shortest path. It will not follow the constant angle. Do you see? Straight line.
So in rum line, it will be constant angle. If you are starting from point A, but it will reach point B, even if we are maintaining the constant angle.
Constant angle.
But right? it will be greater distance.
Yes. But the line will curve according to the latitudes, because latitudes are inclined with each other. Longitudes are inclined with each other. No? So the line will curve to maintain 15 degrees. So the line will curve. So it's a constantly curved line. If you leave or extend the line, constantly curve, it will curve and spiral into pole. Understood? So GC is a straight line track. Rum line is a constantly curved line on Earth, but it maintains correct angle. Understood? It maintains same angle, but it's a constantly curved line. Is this understood, everyone? Any doubts from these two? Any other doubts from these two slides?
No, sir.
Correct. Here, what is the shape of Earth?
Oblate spheroid.
Oblate spheroid. That means, see, if you take this as a sphere, you have compressed it at the poles. Correct. See, at the poles, it is flat. Correct. At the equator, it is not so flat. Now, if you measure one minute, because at the poles, it is flat, if you measure 1 minute, the distance was equal to 1862 meters. Correct. But at the equator, it is sharp. Correct. Kind of sharp. Correct. Kind of sharp like this. So it was only 1843 meters. Understood? So, I mean, they have taken 1 degree and divided into 60 minutes. So 1 minute will be equal to 1843 meters here. At the North Pole, 1 minute will be equal to 1862 meters. How many of you really understood the concept? Why? Because the earth is flat at the poles, na? So it will have more area or more length per 1 minute. Correct. So now they took an average. They took an average at 45 degrees north. At 45 degrees north latitude, they took an average and it measured 1852 meters. Correct. So this they gave as a definition of 1 nautical mile. So 1 nautical mile is equals to 1852 meters, or how much an arc of 1 minute will subtend on Earth. Am I clear? So an arc of great circle which subtends an angle of 1 minute on Earth is called 1 nautical mile. Am I clear? So 1 minute, an arc, this arc should be a GC track, arc of a great circle. Am I clear? So it is taken at 1852 meters. Now,
sir.
Wait, yes.
Can you explain that once? What is 1 nautical mile?
1 second. I'll rub this. See, meridian is a great circle or a great circle track. It is a part of great circle. Correct. Now, because Earth is flat at the poles, if you take 1 degree at the pole, correct, and divide it into 60 parts, what will you get? 1 minute. Correct. So I take 1 degree and divide it into 60 parts and I will get 1 minute. That 1 minute, if I measure at poles, it will be, the distance will be between these two points, it will be 1862 meters. Correct. Now the same distance, if I measure at equator, it will be between 1 minute, it will be 1842 meters, 42 or 43 meters. Correct. But they see there is a difference of 20 meters. Between 1842.
1 minute is equals to, right?
1 minute. 1 minute. Correct. So they said ki here we will take an average at 45 degrees north. 45 degrees north latitude. Here, if you take a degree and divide it into 60 parts, 1 minute will be equal to 1852 meters. And I will call this 1852 meters as 1 nautical mile. Correct. So from the center of Earth, correct, if you subtend an arc on a great circle of 1 minute like this, correct, this angle should be 1 minute. That length of the arc is 1852 meters or 1 nautical mile. How many of you understood?
So that last line, the great circle.
See, on a great circle, correct, if you take 1 degree, and divide it into 60 parts, you will get 1 minute. Correct. on an average, 1 minute, if you measure on Earth, if you take a tape and measure, it will be 1852 meters. Correct. So an arc of on a great circle, which measures 1 minute, will be equal to 1852 meters on average. So that they call as 1 nautical mile. So 1 nautical mile is equals to 1852 meters. Am I clear on this?
Sir, an arc?
An arc of great circle.
Okay.
Which measures, or when an arc of great circle, which is 1 minute, or which substance an angle of 1 minute at the center of Earth. Or simply 1 minute.
Which is 1 minute.
1 minute. On an average, it will be equal to 1852 meters. How did they take average? At poles, it was longer. At equator, it was shorter. So they took at 45 degrees. Correct. So it will be equal to 1852 meters. That is equals to 1 nautical mile. Am I clear on this? But tell me, if 1 minute is equals to 1 nautical mile, correct? 1 minute is equals to 1 nautical mile. How many of you understood? Now 1 degree is equals to how much?
60 nautical mile.
Very good. See, 1 minute has 60 minutes. 1 degree has 60 minutes, correct? So the difference between 44 degrees north and 45 degrees north, if measured on a great circle, the distance would be how much?
60 nautical miles.
Correct. Now, calculate if an aircraft is flying along a meridian. If it is flying along a meridian, it is flying along a great circle track, correct? Because meridian forms a part of great circle. So calculate the distance in nautical miles between equator and the pole. Equator and north pole.
5400.
Correct. See, equator is 0 degrees north or south. Your north pole is how many degrees? 90 degrees north. Correct. So what is the Geelong? How many degrees you are traveling?
90 degrees.
You are traveling 90 degrees towards north. Correct. Now, is this a great circle or a small circle? Meridian. It is a part of great circle, correct? Meridian and anti-meridian will form a great circle. So meridian, I mean, any track following a meridian is a part of great circle. Now, 1 minute.
Meridians are small.
Huh?
Meridians are small circles.
Meridians are semi-great circles. They form a part of great circle, na? Meridian and anti-meridian.
Yes.
Great circle.
Na?
Longitude or small circle, except.
So, 1 minute is equals to 1 nautical mile. Correct. How many degrees are there? 90 degrees. In this 90 degrees, how many minutes are there? 90 into 60 minutes. So these many nautical miles. 9, 6 are? 3, 4? 540 nautical miles. So the distance between the equator and the North Pole is 540 nautical miles.
5400.
Yeah, 5400. I'm sorry. Am I clear? Do I make any sense? Correct. Now, tell me one more example, which is a great circle?
Meridian and anti-meridian.
Of course, I thought I have given an example of meridian. Tell me one more circle here somewhere, which is a great circle?
Equator.
Correct. See, equator is a great circle, na? Yesterday we have discussed. Correct. Now, if you are traveling from 10 degrees, let's say 20 degrees east to, let's say 40 degrees east. What is the Geelong along the equator?
20 east.
20 degrees east, correct. So how many nautical miles? 20 into 60.
1200.
Well, 1 degree is equals to 60 nautical miles, since 1 minute is equals to 1 nautical mile. Correct. 6, 2, 12, 1200 nautical miles. This is how you calculate distances along a great circle. Correct. And of course, you may ask, sir, how I calculate distance between these two points? Because you told this is also a great circle. Correct. That we will learn in further classes, next classes. Understood? This is just telling you the definition of a great circle. That's all. I'm not doing any complicated things in this class. Simple terms. Now, 1 kilometer is equals to how many meters?
1,000.
1852 meters, can I write it as 1.852 kilometers? Correct. So 1 nautical mile is equal to 1852 meters or 1.852 kilometers.
So it is 1.852 kilometer.
Correct. See, 1 meter is equal to how many foot?
3.28
foot. Correct. So 1 nautical mile is equal to how many foot or how many feet?
6080.
Multiply. 1852 meters into 3.28. This will give 6080. Am I clear on this? Let's see. I'll ask you a question, which is a DUCA question, and you have to answer me back. One nautical mile, according to ICOV, is equals to dash. Options are 1852 meters, option B 1.852 meters, option C 6080 feet. Answer please.
Option A, sir.
Mantan. Or all three correct? Maybe someone wants to answer not all three correct. Why not here? Don't you see it?
Sir,
option C.
Okay.
Sir.
Wait. I made a mistake.
This kilometers.
852 kilometers. Now tell me.
Sir, it is feet.
Hmm?
6080
feet.
Yes.
C. Option C.
Option C.
Yes, sir.
Option C by Onkar. Option C by Darwin. Here, why not 1852 meters? 1 nautical mile.
Because in India, we are calculating in feet.
ICAO, is it Indian Civil Aviation Organization or International Civil Aviation Organization?
International.
Then?
Then it is me.
And when did you calculate your distances in feet here in India? Who told you? Like, are you building a building?
No.
In business? No. You calculate vertical distances in feet. Distance you calculate in nautical miles always. Correct. Here, give me an answer here.
1852 meters.
See, the answer is A. Mantan is correct. See, I said according to ICAO. Correct. ICAO has defined 1 nautical mile in meters only. Correct. See, for our convenience, we are using it in kilometers, 1.852 kilometers. Or for our convenience, we are using it in feet. But ICAO has defined in meters only. So in exam, if you see like this, and if there are two correct options, go for 1852 meters. Am I clear on this? See, ICAO definition of nautical mile is that it is measured distance of 1852 meters. It is 1852 meters. Now, see, what they did was they measured the distance in from equator to pole, either north pole or south pole. Correct. Now, they divided each, I mean, this distance into 1,000 equal parts. And they called each part as 1 kilometer. This is how they initially said, ki, yaar, this is from here to here, this distance will be 1 kilometer. How did they do it? They measured the average distance between equator and the pole, and they divided it into 1,000 parts and measured it as 1 kilometer. Correct. Now calculate the distance between equator, correct, two poles in kilometers. Here. See, here, who is calculating? Don't calculate with your brains. Think on it. See, if I take the distance between equator and pole and divide into 10,000 parts, and each part I say it as 1 kilometer. Now, what is the distance between equator and poles?
10,000 kilometer.
Very good. Correct. See, this is 1 kilometer. This is 1 more kilometer. This is 1 more kilometer. One more. How many parts are there? 10,000 parts.
10,000.
Correct.
Yes, sir.
So distance between equator and poles, if you are following around a meridian, it is how much? 10,000 kilometers. Am I clear? Correct. Now, this was the question asked in my exam. Correct. Calculate circumference of Earth
in nautical miles.
Option A. Option B. C. Option A, 40,000. Kilometers. Option B, 40,000 nautical miles. Option C, 40,000. Answers, please.
C, sir. C.
What?
C.
Calculate the circumference of Earth.
40,000. Not kilometers.
Onkar.
Darwin. Sir, I think A and C both are correct.
Very good. Very good. See.
If they ask according to ICO, then C.
See, that question is a stock question. That will not change. They will ask only definition of nautical mile according to ICO. Correct. That will be 1852 meters. Okay, don't apply it everywhere.
Okay. Yes, sir.
Do you see here? From equator to the pole, if I divide into 1,000 parts, each part is 1 kilometer. So the distance between the equator and the pole is 10,000 kilometers. Is this understood, Arsh? Correct. Now, if you go to the opposite side, so 10,000 plus 10,000, how much?
20,000.
Now you go down to South Pole, one more 10,000.
30,000.
And you come back to the original place.
40,000.
40,000. Correct.
Sir, that 40,000 kilometers on nautical miles, I got confused.
Kilometers, sir. See, the definition of kilometer is you divide the distance between the equator and the pole 10,000 times. Correct. So, one part is equals to 1 kilometer. Correct. So, this will be 10,000 kilometers, 20,000 kilometers, niche 30, and then 40,000 kilometers. Am I clear, Omkar?
Yes.
Now see, I said this is also a great circle, na? Because you are following the meridians and antimeridians, correct? So if you are starting from here and going totally around the globe, how many degrees you are traveling?
360
degrees you are traveling. So each 1 minute is equals to 1 nautical mile on a great circle. So 1 degree is equals to 60 minutes. So it will be 60 nautical miles. Correct. So 360 degrees is called how many nautical miles? 360 into, because 1 degree is 60 nautical miles, 360 into 60, that would be 21600 nautical miles. So there are two answers in this question, option A and option C. How many of you really understood? Raise your hands. How many of you want one more explanation? Raise your hands. Okay. Onkar, tell me the part which you did not understand.
This 21,600 answer explanation.
Okay. If you go around the earth along a great circle, correct, how many degrees you are traveling?
180.
Oh. If you travel 180, you will go to pole and to equator. You have to come back. Yeah.
The full it is 360.
360, na? So if you are traveling 360 degrees, 1 degree is 60 nautical miles. So 360 degrees, how many nautical miles? Okay. Any more doubts? Here, guys, turn your cameras on here. I am getting bored. Done. Shall I move on? Okay. So that is the definition of DECA. It is the 1,000th part of the average distance between equator and the pole. Length 1 kilometer is equals to 3 to 8. Okay, fine. So 1 kilometer is equals to how many meters? Kilo is 10^3, correct? So 1,000 meters. Everybody knows this, no confusion, correct? So 1 meter is equals to how many foot? 3.28 feet. So 1 kilometer is equals to how many meters? So how many feet?
3040.
Yeah, 1 meter. See, 1 meter is 3.28 feet, correct? So 1 kilometer will be 3280 feet. Is this understood? Correct. 1 nautical mile was how many foot?
6080 foot.
Correct. Now there is one more entity called a statue mile. Some countries in the UK, I believe, use statue miles. Not allowed to use in aviation anymore. Okay. It is very rare that you see some conversions related to statue miles, but for easy purposes, you have to remember this. 1 statue mile is equals to 5280 feet. Am I clear? 1 statute mile is equals to 5280 feet. Now, if you ask me, sir, how these many numbers, na, how, what all I should remember? Okay. I'll tell you what all you should remember. Here, 1 meter is equals to 3.28 feet. This you have to remember. I cannot do anything about it. Correct. Now, if you know this, you will know 1 kilometer is equals to 3,280 feet. Because just you are multiplying this value into 1,000. Correct. 1 nautical mile was how many feet?
1852 meters,
na?
How feet? 6080 feet.
1 statue mile is equals to how many feet?
5280.
Now, if I zoom in, see 80 is very common, correct? So 3.28 feet. You remember because 1 meter is 3.28. So you always remember this value, 3280 feet, correct? It need not be separately memorized, correct? 3.2 will become 5.2 if you take statue miles, and at nautical mile it will become 6.0, correct? Because 80 is common. This is how I remember, and I remember it forever. Correct. So 3-2 will become 5-2, 5-2 will become 6-0. This should be by heart, correct? In wake sleep, month and year statue mile 5-2-8-0. Month and year nautical mile 6-0-8-0. Am I clear on this?
Sir, I'm taking down 1 second.
So today, are you going to take med class?
No, yeah.
Sir, how to remember this?
See, 8-0 is common for everyone. So 3-2, 5-2, 6-0. Correct. See, you know 1 kilometer, 1 meter is 3.28 feet. Correct. So 1 kilometer will be 3-2-8-0 feet. This you remember. Correct. 3-2 will become 5-2. 5-2 will become 6-0. Correct. That's how I remember. And I don't know why. Once I thought this kind of thing, it got stuck in my brain. Now, your last concept, geocentric and geodetic latitudes. See, is the earth flat? Oh, sorry, is the earth perfect sphere?
No, sir.
No, no. It is compressed like this. Correct. Now, if I am standing here, let's say at 45 degrees, correct. If I am standing here at 45 degrees, now tell me what is like from here you measure 1 degree, 2 degree, 4 degree, 5 degree, so on and so forth, like 45 degrees, you will be here and you will call, you are at, sir, Vamshi sir, you are at 45 degrees north. This is how you tell, correct? But see, that means, see, this is the equator, agree? Equator, correct. If you go here, that means with the center of earth, you are sustaining an angle of, let's say, 10 degrees, correct. If you go here, so from the center of earth again, let's say this is 5 degrees, let's say this is 10 degrees, correct. So this will be 20 degrees, correct. So this, if you are standing here, correct, at this point, so from the center of earth, if you measure, you are at 45 degrees north. This is how you calculated latitudes, correct? Is this understood, everybody? But now see, imagine I am at 45 degrees north, correct? Now, if I put a hole directly into the earth, correct, and I go inside, correct. See, will I go to the center of earth? Exactly center of earth? No. Because the earth is flat, na? I am, if I put a hole and go inside, I will meet somewhere here. Understood? Not here. Correct. If earth was perfect sphere, if I put a direct hole in this way, it will exactly reach the center. But see, the earth is not a perfect sphere. So if I put the a hole here, correct, if I put a hole here, because it is not a perfect sphere, it is flat at the poles, na? It is flat at the poles, na? So earth is not a perfect sphere, so it will reach this place. How many of you understood this? Correct. Now, if you measure this angle, it will not be 45, it will be 50 degrees. It will be more than 45 degrees. Understood? Generally, it will not be 50 degrees. It will be 45 degrees, 11.6 minutes. Correct? I'll come to that. Okay. Now, in first case, how did you measure your latitude with respect to center of earth? Correct. So that is called as geocentric latitude is the angle between the observer and the center of the earth, geocenter of the earth. If you measure latitude like that, that is called as geocentric latitude. Correct. Now, if you measure by drawing a normal to the observer, correct? If I am standing like this, correct? Normal means like into the earth, like you're going inside. Exactly. But that will not reach the center, no, because the earth, no, you see, it is curved or it is compressed at the poles. There is a compression to earth. So you will reach here, correct? And if you measure the angle like that, correct? If you measure the angle like this, so it will be a bit more than this, no? See, do you see the red angle is less than the blue angle? Correct. Can you make the difference? Correct. So the red angle is like this. The blue angle is like this. Which is more? Is this or is this? This is more, correct? This is less. Correct. So can I, this angle, if you measure with by drawing a normal, it is called as geographic. That means graphy. How is the earth at my position? That will determine where I will reach at the center of earth. Correct. So geographic or geodetic latitude is the angle between the normal to the observer's horizontal plane and the equatorial plane. How many of you understood? Raise your hands. Correct. So see, can I say geographic? See, this is geocentric. Geocentric. So this is geographic or geodetic. Can I say always geographic or geodetic will be more than geocentric latitude? Correct. Except at the equator, both will be zero. Correct. At the poles, both will be 90 degrees. Correct. Because at the poles, if you stand, if you come down, you will exactly come to the center of earth, geocenter of the earth. Correct. So geocentric latitude will also be same. Geodetic latitude will also be same. Correct. So can I say geographic latitude or geodetic latitude will always exceed geocentric latitude, except at poles and equator, except at equator and poles. Is this line understood? Yeah, these are not question marks. Like these are bullet points. Conversion between Apple and Windows, because I type everything in PowerPoint, na? It will, I have the conversion issue. They both fight, Windows and Apple. Correct. Now see, at the equator, it is zero. The difference between geographic and geodetic, because both are zero. At poles, it is again zero because both are 90. 90 minus 90 will be zero. Correct. The difference between, like, they both measure same. Correct. Now at a 45 degrees, na, they have a maximum difference. That difference will be equals to 11.6 minutes. Correct. So the difference between the geographic or geodetic and geocentric latitude is maximum at a 45 degrees north, and it is equals to 11.6 minutes. And this is given a name called as equation of time. Correct. So what is this equation of time? Not needed for aviation, but because this is very frequently asked kind of stock question in DGCA, we have to know. It has a lot of importance in determining a climate or something related to Earth. Correct. Am I understood? Correct. Any doubt in this slide? Geocentric, geographic or geodetic, and why the difference is zero at equator and poles, and where is it maximum? Maximum is at 45 degrees which is 11.6 minutes. It is given a name which we will just remember it without asking many questions. Equation of time. Correct.
Sir, we studied equation of time in another chapter, I think.
In solar system and time.
Yes, sir.
We'll discuss later.
16 minutes.
Sir.
Yes.
Sir, it is zero at poles and equator.
It is zero at poles and equator. See, at poles, if you stand and draw a, like take a drilling machine and go directly, see, you will reach the center. So, and at poles and equator, it will be zero.
And maximum at?
What? It is maximum at 45 degrees north. That is equation of time. Here, this completes our first chapter. How many of you understood every point of the chapter? Raise your hands. Ongar. I believe. And Harsh, don't worry. You missed one class. That will be taken care of. Okay. Fine. I'll see. Yes.
That 11.6 is equation of time.
Correct.
It is the difference between that geocentric and this thing.
Geodetic latitudes at 45 degrees north.
Okay.